here. Thanks for stopping by. I'm driving home from Colorado. I'm still in Colorado. And I'm thinking about flipping the switch. This is a theme that's been on my mind for a couple of months or longer, maybe a few months now. And it's kind of a mental exercise that I do when I catch myself thinking a negative thought or telling myself a shitty story, is that I just stop and just flip the switch in my mind. It's kind of like a kill switch, but the point just being I just stop that train of thought and switch it to a more positive storyline, a more positive frame of thought. And in my past, I've had a lot of struggle early in the morning, a lot of days that started off unproductively because I laid in bed ruminating about the things that weren't making me happy in my life, and I would start crying before I even got out of bed, and then it would take me several hours to kind of snap myself back in a productive state, if at all. Some days I would stay in that down emotional state for the whole day, and then it would start to spiral. And I'm talking about this because I know I'm not alone in that. I've talked to a number of my friends who have expressed that they have a similar difficulty with waking up in a good place, starting their day in a good productive place. And as I've been studying successful people and leaders for a couple of decades now, that is probably the most critical thing that I run into, is that successful people start their days well, generally, and have a routine of priming themselves for a good day, as opposed to people who are struggling tend to have a routine of starting their day off poorly and then struggling to catch up or struggling to change that throughout the day or sometimes the year or the lifetime. And so I just want to let you know that it's possible to change. It just takes making up your mind that you want to change. And if you have decided that you want to be happy, that you want to live a productive life, that you want to be a great person, that you want to feel grateful for your great life on a regular basis, then I encourage you and urge you to take a check of your morning routine and your evening routine too, or your whole day routine, but in particular, check that morning routine. And if you've, I know a lot of people who say, well, and I was one of those people who was like, I just end up crying for no reason before I even get out of bed, and I don't seem to have control over it, and I think it's beyond my control. I think it has to do with my body or my circumstances or my hormones. And I can tell you that I have developed that habit for decades, and so it's been a slow couple year process, and I still struggle with it sometimes, but I have made leaps and bounds of improvement. And just this week I was visiting a friend, so I was sleeping out of my comfort zone and found myself with some time to lay in bed without. So when I'm at home, I kind of have a routine where as soon as I notice if I'm starting to ruminate in bed, I get up and I start talking about the things I'm grateful for, and I pet my pets, and I get to my routine. And so it's easier at home now that I've been establishing that routine to snap myself into it. But when I'm traveling, which I intend to do even more in the future, I find it sometimes a little challenging, more challenging or challenging in a different way, because things are different and my sleep schedule is a little different. And anyhow, I was just wanting to let you know that I feel proud of myself and successful in catching myself with those ruminating thoughts and flipping the switch. And it still takes doing. It's not like I just learned it one time and then it's done forever. I still have to work at it, but the more I work at it, the easier it gets. And so in past parts of my life, I might have ended up destroying relationships or, you know, having a really crappy day, 1 out of 3, just because I couldn't pull myself out of that state. And now that I've been practicing and I'm really convinced that it's possible to change my brain, change my habits, change my story, as I practice that, it gets easier and easier. So this trip was absolutely wonderful, and those few moments that I struggled a little bit, actually I'm using as a trigger to feeling better about myself. I really do feel proud that I was able to catch myself in those moments, and instead of just giving into them, just flipping the switch and knowing that, no, I want to have a good time. I want to have good relationships. I want to have a productive day, and ruminating on what I have to complain about never helps any of that. So as soon as I catch myself complaining out loud or internally to myself, I just stop. It doesn't help to beat myself up either, because that just creates more of the same. But to just stop and just acknowledge that I deserve happiness, I choose happiness, and therefore I can have happiness just by changing my thoughts, changing my attitude, changing my routine. So that's my 2 cents for this morning. I encourage you, if you're unhappy, if you like being unhappy, then hey, go at it. But if you want to be happy and you're having trouble being happy, or you want to be productive and successful and you're not feeling like you're as productive and successful as you want to be, I encourage you to examine what could help and take a little step in that direction, and then give yourself a proverbial pat on the back or an actual pat on the back. You know, reward yourself, praise yourself when you do good, and let it go when you don't do good. Just recognize that that's part of the process, and beating yourself up doesn't help at all. So if you want to change, you can. It takes time, it takes energy, and yet it actually just takes that split second of deciding, and maybe more than one time, but the split second you decide, I want to be happy and I know I deserve to be happy, instead of, why can't I be happy, or why is everybody always picking on me, all those cliche things that human beings do tend to think. Instead, think, I am in control of my life, I can make myself happy, I can make my life good, and then go about doing that. Thanks for joining me. That's my 2 cents. Till next time, peace, love, prosperity, possibilities, and positivity.